Hello everyone, myself Professor Tushar Gujarati from S&D College of Engineering and Research Center, Yola. Today we'll study open loop and closed loop systems in mechatronics. So what is open loop and closed loop systems? We'll study one by one. So now this is open loop system. So any system we have to give some input. So this is input. So suppose one process is there. To that process we require some input. So input is given to that process and then we get output. So input is given to process and process gives us some output. Okay. So here one example is shown, open loop control system. So open loop control modifies output based on predetermined control values. There is no actual measurement of control quantity. So you understand this. Now there is one tank is shown. Okay. So this is the tank having height h. Okay, so here q input is nothing but fluid is flowing inside this tank and q output is fluid is coming out through this tank. Okay, and here control element is shown, final control element and controller. Okay, this is control valve. What happens here in this open loop system? So we have predetermined control values. So what is written here? Predetermined control values. So this setting of this control valve is done predetermined. Okay, this setting is predetermined. So that's why this control valve has valve setting already done. Okay, and it gives us output flow, and then tank gives us tank level. Okay. So what happens here? Suppose some disturbances are occurred in this tank. So what will happen? Tank level will get decreased or increased. Okay. So this tank level we cannot control in open loop system because we are not using here controller. Okay. So open loop system does not use any controller, and that's why tank level cannot be controlled here. Only input is given and output will get produced because we have set control valve already in predetermined. It is already set and we cannot change that setting. Okay, that's why the tank level may vary with outside disturbances and system changes. This happens in open loop system. Now try to understand closed loop system. In the closed loop system, suppose one process is there, so we give input to that process. Okay, and process generates some output. Now this output is sensed with the help of some sensor. Okay, so here it is written monitor. Monitor monitors the output and compares it with input. So output is compared with input with the help of comparator. And what happens here? Compare and adjust action takes place. Compare and adjust, and this entire process is called as feedback loop. Okay, so here comparison takes place, that's why it is called as feedback loop. So now you check this closed control loop example. So you try to read this statement. Closed loop control modifies output based on measured value of the control variable. So here we measure the output. Okay, and according to that output we modify the control action. Measured value compared to desired value and used to maintain desired value when disturbances occur. So here what happens, the measured value is compared with desired value always. Okay, and this closed loop control uses feedback of output to input. Now you try to understand with this diagram. So here we are going to control level of the tank. So our output is tank level we have to control. So we have already set towards input what is our desired value. Okay, so level measurement, what happens? Level measurement, it measures level and gives it input to this comparator. So comparator compares the level at output side and input side and generates some error. So this error is given to this controller. Okay, controller gives signal to this control valve, and control valve either gets open or closed because of this control signal, and it tries to maintain the desired value in this tank. Okay, so like this, the desired level in the tank can be maintained with the help of this control valve because of this level measurement. So this is called as feedback. Whatever this action is there, it is called as feedback. Okay, feedback signal. And this entire is called as closed loop control system. So this is entirely closed loop control system. Now one more example is shown over here, auto cruise control. Okay, so in this case we have to control the speed of the automobile. Okay, we are going to control speed of the automobile, so that's why we require here speed sensor. So we have used here speed sensor. Here we get actual speed and here it is set speed. Okay, so actual speed is sensed by this speed sensor and it is compared here with the help of comparator. So comparator compares set speed and actual speed and it generates error if error is present, and this error is given to this controller. Controller sends signal to fuel injectors. So fuel injectors increases or decreases the fuel supply to this engine, and according to that automobile speed either increases or decreases, and we get the desired speed at the output side. So we get desired speed or set speed at the output side. So like this, the actual speed is compared with set speed and we get control action properly. This is also one type of closed loop control system. And actually many disturbances occur when automobile moves uphill, downhill, heat wind, tail wind. So these are some disturbances which reduces the actual speed of the automobile, and that actual speed we have to control. And what is meaning of auto cruise control system? Automatic speed of the vehicle is controlled with the help of auto cruise control system. So you should remember this. Now this is generalized closed loop control system. So in this system the input is called as set point. Okay, this is called as set point, and output is called as control variable C. Okay, and here it is CM. CM is nothing but measured variable. That is, we are going to measure from sensor. Okay, and here difference between this set point value and CM, we get error. Okay, so this error is given to this control modes. So here V is nothing but controller output, then M is nothing but manipulated output, and at the end point we get again control variable. Okay, so these are some, what we can say, these are some nomenclature of this closed loop control system. So like this closed loop control system works. And inside these blocks the transfer function is written. G is equal to V upon E. That is, V is output and E is input. So output upon input is called as transfer function. So G is nothing but, this is output and input is E. So V upon E is nothing but GC. Here GM is nothing but M upon V, output upon input. Here GP is nothing but output is C, input is M. So C upon M is nothing but GP. Okay, so like this we get. And here in this case output is on this side, input is this. So output is CM and input is C. That's why ratio is CM upon C. So like this we get transfer functions very easily. So 7 races of technologies are shown here. Capital investments, time is required, tools and machines are required, raw materials, people, energy, knowledge. So everything is required for any closed loop system or open loop system. So this is called as Captain Crunch, Crunch Berries. So input, first step in both the systems. Okay, input is first step in both the systems. Other words that mean input are data, information, plan, what you want. So these are all inputs. Process, what is process? It is second step in both the systems. This is where you do the work. Okay, the 7 resources of technology fit under process. Output, what is output? This is the third step in both the systems. The output is your finished product should be very close to your input. So it is finished product should be very close to your input. This is the output. And what is monitor? The monitor is only on the closed loop system to look over something. So this is the feedback part. Feedback sensor are used. So monitor is only the closed loop system to look over something. So both compare and adjust are on the closed loop system only. In the closed loop system, we get only compare and adjust option. Compare, this is the step is where you look at the input and the output. You want them to be very similar. And what is adjust? This is where you will change things that are not similar in the input and output. You do not always need to adjust. Okay, if input and output is not similar, at that time only you have to adjust, otherwise don't adjust. Okay, so this happens in case of compare and adjust. So thank you so much all of you for watching this video. Thank you.